We're at Lama Tzong Khapa Institute in Italy with our Venerable Lama Tupten Yeshe, just after His Holiness the Dalai Lama has left. And we would like to continue to ask Lama some questions about the development of the centers throughout the world, and perhaps some advice on how Lama feels about the development and the future direction of the centers. Lama, how did the very first center outside of Nepal develop? How did it begin?
First of all, many years ago, that many students came to search something for their certification in India, Nepal. And then many students sort of asking me to come, instead of they have to come all the way. You know, better, you have to come to West. And first beginning, I'm a little bit shaking. Yeah, uneasy, you know, such simple monkey in the going to, you know, super samsara world. But I accepted, you know, the invitation. And it was 1974. And then I went to America and give several lectures. Then after that, I went to Australia, at Queensland, and I give 1 month course there, and that is the sort of cooperative course, and student decided, you know, they should have, you know, the center to facilitate the Buddha Dharma teaching. And their, you know, dedication, their is very strong. And I say, okay, if you want, that is your baby, you're welcome. And also, they donated land about 160 acres from by the, you know, Dr. Ney and Yeshe Kandru and Tom and Kathy.
So it was only four people who were mainly responsible for the first center beginning, or was it a larger group?
Well, large group expresses, but particularly, you know, and these are the people actively involving and completely dedicated, and they're giving their life and their body, speech, mind for developing this center.
By that time, had most of the students in Australia already been to Nepal?
Yeah, many are. Many are, yes, that time too. Yes. Then it is just an empty place, you know, and then they built meditation compa and residential geshe's room and the student. Apartment, you know, and that way, sort of naturally, it developed up to now.
Now, that was the very first center that actually developed practically. Did you, for the other centers that came afterwards, follow the example of that as an experience to draw from?
I think so. Somehow, it is a nature, you know. Each time I went different country, and there are already collectively student previous, you know, Nepal, and they say they, you know, sort of, you know, no question, and they express it, they like to be somehow group gathering and putting energy. I personally, it is very reasonable. I thought they are very sincerity, you know, And in Western world, and such orientation of heavy samsara, you know, students went back, they lost their head, you know. You know what I mean, you know? Yes. I understand. I completely understand Western, you know, environment is so, you know, exploited, you know, superstition, pollution of the mind. And I can understand the baby of their understanding, taking refuge, understanding, lumbering is so baby, so they disappear sometimes, you know. And I thought it is something essential, what they're asking, their life to be groomly evolving and to carry, continue that they are practicing. I thought it's so natural. And so I let go, you know, I let go. I didn't say I don't want a center, you know. I just told them, center is your baby, you know. What I can do is blah, 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 you know. Then say goodbye.
So you thought one of the main reasons for the centers in the West was to continue the practice of the Dharma.
Exactly.
In a good environment.
Exactly, yes.
Because what reason?
Because in, you know, Western environment, it is totally, you know, I mean, set up, which is anti, you know, practicing of Dharma or anti-practice of religion. Even though West, we do have, you know, religion, you know, I understand now why Western religions degenerated, you know, because the orientation of, you know, environment, which is sort of overwhelming, you know, sort of explosion of the dualistic, you know, delusion, you know, and this is the, I understand. So therefore, I also not only accepted their, you know, wanted to center, I told them somehow, you know, it is essential we making correct, you know, environment in order to, you know, sort of, you know, sort of living the confrontation, you know, sort of developing confrontation, intensive awareness, you know, and to training and the readiness to go, you know, such a polluted city, you know.
So did you see then the one of the main purposes of the centers as an actual physical place for of refuge?
That's right. Exactly what you say. Exactly. Because I feel my own experience, you know, my own taking refuge, I feel each year I need go retreat, strict retreat, you know, and then I can cope my life maybe, you know, you understand, and my blah, blah, blah is useful. And I feel same thing West student, when they are working such environment in the city, a city, they need each year at least, you know, certain, you know, amount of time, space to go exclusive meditation. And that's why I think it's very, very useful. Otherwise, we put so much energy, short period, or 1 month, 2 months. After they go back, their environment completely vanishes. So I think it's not worthwhile. To bring in Dharma West world is something we are continuously development. And it carry, you know, to the generation to generation, not just sort of trip, you know. And I think that's why to establish it, especially community style, living situation, and shared situation, to be exercised, you know, Mahayana, you know, universal concepts into the daily living life, I think that is very, very important. Because what is the problem in Western world is we are capitalistic attitude and we are materialistic attitude. So thereby, we are too much, you know, individualistic, you know, selfish attitude, not sharing each other, you know. And this is the, you know, you cannot avoid. That is the, you know, the foundation built up society. So we need some way to break down such concepts, or of transforming that energy into the something sort of, you know, transcendent, you know, a peaceful, you know, experience.
So then, do you consider that there would be, from the point of view of the members of the community, that there are basically two purposes that are served with the centers? One is that it should be a place, there should be places where communities can develop, but there should also be, from what I understand that you're saying, a place for people from outside to come on a regular basis, as their own time allows, to, shall we say, strengthen their practice for their living outside in the daily world.
That's right, yes.
So we have two divisions.
Yes, two divisions we are same time doing so far up to now. And we're seeing some problem too.
Yes.
Because when we are involving community living situation at the center, because then we are involving children, husband, wife, lifestyle, you know, and this made sometimes environment is again sort of very much, you know, shaking, you know, disorder. And so the people who come outside expecting intensive training and meditation, and then sometimes they disturb, you know. So therefore, I think now we have to, you know, reconsider maybe, you know, community living situation, something separate than the, you know, center training people to peaceful, you know, environment they should have.
Has this understanding really come out of practical experience of the centers in their dealing with the problems they face when they do have mixed communities and they have people like you described coming from outside expecting discipline and seeing there is a mixed feeling? You feel it's now appropriate to consider more of a division within the communities between lay people and people following the monastic disciplines? Or?
Well, no. People living at the center community, they feel their nature, you know. Their nature to have children, you know. I feel also myself, you know, you make community, so there is children, there is husband, there is wife, there is everything, you know. Community means my vision. I mean, of course, my vision, I tell you. Now, I talk about practical point of view, then my vision is different, I tell you, you know. Particularly, that's happening now. But my project, my vision is community development means sort of universal totality. It means community, in the community, we have space for the, you know, monk and the nuns, space for the family, space for children, you know, space for from beginning up to end of human, you know, growth. And this is my, you know, sort of projection. But of course, I've been dealing with, you know, materialistic life, you know, in order to make this possible, it's involving tremendous, you know, money and energy. You understand? So therefore, we try to beginning utilize energy what we have. So that hopefully, in the future, I can see it develop itself because it is need, you know, seen by the student. I hope in the future we have, you know, everything is, you know, need is fulfilled.
Right.
Instead of, you know, one place, everything happening, you know, and the result is uneasy, you know, and sometimes confusion too.
So, Lama, do you think then it's for the future development of the centers that the areas of activity of the different centers internally should be very clearly defined? Do you think that needs to happen now, or do you think it's going to develop? Like you described, like the if you have a grand vision of the communities fulfilling all purposes,
yes.
Then you have the monastic side,
yeah.
You have the family side,
yeah.
You have the children's side,
yeah.
And possibly also you have a college or
yes.
study side.
That's right.
You also possibly
also
have meditation.
Artistic, you know, school,
mm.
you know, and also sort of creation, and the musical, you know, dancing. I feel, I mean, really, making community is the sort of universal energy. We cannot deny, you know, dancing and the singing is something part of, you know, our nature. So therefore, if really we want to make, you know, some kind of, you know, society, you know, some kind of, you know, really peaceful, you know, and, you know, Mahayana society, we have to accept all these things. And what we have right now into the, you know, samsara, everything should have it into this society, you know, as transforming, you know, into the some kind of utilizing in part to liberation. Yes.
So you don't see, with the proper attitude, any contradiction for a community to celebrate its feeling of togetherness in something such as a party or in dance or
it's all
something
right.
like this?
It's all right. It's part of our life, you know.
Mm.
We have to accept it, you know.
Mm.
Of course, you know, different people, you know, and when you are involving community, in the community, different people choose again different life. Even though we have completely common universal sense to actualize Mahayana attitude, isn't it? But still we play, you know. Some walk and touch flower, red flower maybe, some touch white flower, some touch, you know, yellow flower, isn't it? To play. I think that that should be acceptable.
Mm-hmm.
It's still confession of life. And the most important thing is to have, you know, those things, you know, to interpret it.
Mm-hmm.
Red flower interpreted, you know, divine red light, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I mean? White flower is interpreted as you know, the pure white light, you know, to purifying, you know, one's one negativity and transforming energy into kundalini, blissful energy, maybe you can say what I mean, you know. So that kind of interpretation we need. And the significant, diluted signify, you know, the meaning transforming into the divine, you know, sort of energy.
Now, for that to take place, obviously we need to receive teachings. We need to receive
sure.
clear instructions from qualified teachers.
Understand.
And one of the great fortunate things that you have been able to provide nearly all the centers with is very, very highly qualified teachers. Would you like to say something, Lama, about, first of all, about the teachers themselves that you have chosen and how you feel the communities should look to those teachers in their centers?
Mm-hmm. Well, I feel that we are, you know, something involving bigger scope, you know. Therefore, if I'm thinking I can do everything, it's just an ego trip, you know. You understand? I cannot do anything. I cannot do everything, you know. So therefore, you know, I really believe what I choose those teachers, those geishas or drukas, whatever it is, in the center, you know. You know, I really believe, you know, I trust them, you know, to lead my student or my center to benefit, you know, large scale, international levels or universal levels, or, you know, to bring, you know, Mahayana thought, you know, a universal, you know, attitude. And therefore, my understanding is all the students involved there, they should look, you know, as, you know, their spiritual leaders, you know, isn't it? And that they should have good communication, you know, reasonable communication with the spiritual leaders.
What has been the basis of your selection of the teachers for the centers?
Well, I try as much as I could, you know. Something, you know, those teachers have sort of, well, you know, training and intellectually and psychologically, philosophically, and practically, you know, or most of them, what I choose is also same, you know, disciple of the same guru as I do, you know. So I believe they have same, you know, they're better quality, maybe, you know. Some of them is same quality, maybe because we are same kind of race, you know. Some of them better quality than me. So therefore, I think we do have similar, you know, things to offer for the student.
Did you approach them to ask them to go to the centers? Or did some of them come to you?
Not really, you know. You know, those the teachers, they really not, some of them not keen, you know, to go in the West, you know. Yeah. Then I choose what, you know, please go to teach them.
So you really have to put some pressure.
Yes.
On them to leave the Tibetan communities.
Yes, sometimes, yes. Mm-hmm. That's right, yes.
So that really they've been making quite great sacrifice from,
yes,
their, from their
some
own,
of them, yeah,
from
some
their
of
own
them.
Commitments.
Yeah, some of them also push, you know, they want to,
yes,
go. You know? I don't know what that means, too, you know. So what can I say?
Everybody likes a broader experience.
Yeah, I think so, yeah, I think so, yeah.
What do you think the, from the point of view of the teachers' responsibility in the centers, how should the community members look at the teachers for the responsibility of the general program, the general activities of the centers?
Mm-hmm. Well, that things, I think, is very important to have, you know, sort of broad view, and to have sort of, you know, strong attitude to sharing, you know, the idea, the between the, you know, our teachers, you know, geishas or lamas or tulguns or whatever, and the directors and the spiritual directors Western. So I feel without linking, without a strong connection, without making firm, you know, connection, understanding each other, it's very difficult to be useful, you know, making programs, making, you know, presentations. So therefore, it is all important. Everything is so important.
You understand what I mean? Communication.
Yes.
Between the members of the community about their activities and their future projects,
planning
and so forth, should be really closely.
Yes, closely.
Closely linked with the teachers themselves.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. If teachers or student, the planning, you know, directors, not communication, mm-hmm. I think my understanding is not so good vibration, you know. Then we cannot, you know, give Mahayana thought, you know.
Becomes
I
limited.
Think, yes, because it's conflicting, you know. Mm-hmm. If you conflict, you know, if, for example, you are the director, Brian, you are director of Lama Tzong Khapa Institute, I'm the teacher here. Mm-hmm. If you and me, something, you know, break down, you know, and I think that is most, you know, I mean, disaster, mm-hmm. and the root is break down. You understand what I mean?
Absolutely.
Absolutely, you know. Mm-hmm. I feel, you know, to bring Dharma Western world is something really special, isn't it? Mm. Something really you have to, you know, I mean, you know, you have to sort of, you know, give up your personality. Some of your personality have to die, mm. isn't it? And then link it some of the, you know, Western, you know, personality. And this way we both are, you know, sort of putting together energy forcefully, and then we become successful.
So I think it's very important then for whoever's involved in a position of responsibility in the community to always, as much as possible, keep the broader aim
yes.
of the community Absolutely. In mind.
Absolutely, you know.
And not to be limited by their, perhaps, individual no. wishes.
I don't think so. Anyway, individualistic is the problem, isn't it? In the world now.
Always.
You understand?
Yes.
So, I mean, I don't believe, you know. I don't know, I don't believe. Even if my student tried to me, sort of says, Lama, you are the my blah, 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 something like that, you know. I think they're rubbish, you know. Mm-hmm. And there are the, you know, I put Geshe, who are responsible, they should take teaching from them, you know. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. And take advantage and grow into that atmosphere. Mm-hmm. Don't you think? Very important.
There's been some sort of problems in the past, I think, Lama, when people are not sure in the communities, people are not sure how much the teachers should actually give advice for the development of the community. And what is your feeling about this? Because Mm-hmm. There has been problems.
Mm, I understand something now. Now, I think there's many different development stage. Mm. First of all, many teachers come, you know, mm-hmm. from India, and really first time. They are culturally shocked. Yeah. You understand?
Yes.
It's true.
Yes.
You know, and then presentation of, you know, the West Center is something put in very strange. You know, mm-hmm. it's nothing to do with the, you know, orientation of Tibetan style. You understand?
Yes.
So maybe they feel, you know. What kind of Dharma, you know? You understand?
Yes.
I mean, something, you know, may be disturbed, you know? Mm-hmm. So therefore, first beginning stage, you know, I mean, maybe, even, you know, it's involving trying to give advice, it's putting very hard. Mm-hmm. For my opinion is, I let go. What I tell for the beginning, mm-hmm. say, you are responsible, to put this center up or down, mm-hmm. you know?
To whom?
And I tell those geshes, you know? Mm-hmm. You know, you are the responsible. Mm-hmm. You put this center, brings up, or you put down, or you are responsible. Mm-hmm. I just tell, you know? But you, as much you could, you do. And you have spiritually to direct all these people's mind. Mm-hmm. Plus, if you want, the committee meeting, you are the right to have come to committee meeting, mm-hmm. isn't it? You are committee, translator of both committee, and they are the equally right to say, you know, mm-hmm. what if their, you know, contribution to development of the center. Mm-hmm. So that sometimes Geshe says, I don't want. Now this is my talk about my experience. Mm-hmm. Some Geshe says, I don't want to involve in anything with the samsara involvement. You know, they want only liberation, you know,
just
some
teaching.
Geshe's. I say, let go. How can you push, you know? Okay, let go. And some geshe's want, you know, to talk and involve with the community. I'm very happy, you know, very happy. I think if they have, you know, wisdom and, you know, method to make center, you know, growing, most beneficial way, but as much possible for the human mind, mm. then, you know, it's worthwhile to involve. Mm-hmm. So the, my style is I give just freedom, option, whatever they want to do. You know.
So then it requires, as I understand from this, that it does require then for the Western students themselves in the different centers, and especially those who are in a position of maybe a director or a position of responsibility, that they have also, from their side, to exercise quite a degree of wisdom in making judgment on whether the Geshe is ready to give advice, or whether they are themselves the people in responsibility to give the directions.
Yes, absolutely, you know.
So they have to judge.
Absolutely, you know, some extent, yes. Mm. Because when they judge, oh, that is a different language again, you know. Mm. I mean, they have to, you know, if they instead of judge use language, you know, I say, if Geshe do, okay. If Geshe doesn't do, that is to have to make direct decision. You know, decision. Mm. Otherwise, nobody makes decision, place becomes disorder. You know?
Yes,
right?
Exactly.
And at that time, also, I mean, also Geshe's side, one should not feel, you know, he make decision, you know. Mm-hmm. If he, I'm not make decision, somebody has make decision, so you make decision, I may let go. I say, I'm happy, you know. Mm. You know, if I'm criticized, it's created, you know, again, negative, you know. Mm-hmm. I think...
To what extent, this is on the same subject, to what extent do you think the community members themselves should be involved in the, I don't mean the specific day-to-day running, but in general decisions about the future of the community.
Yes, we do.
Because this has sometimes created problems.
I know. We do have, now I tell you, our system is, we have all total community meeting. Mm-hmm. And we talk about problem, or good or bad, what is the daily, you know, and what is the future program is right or wrong. We investigate, we talk openly. They can exercise anything, you know. Mm. I believe everybody has wisdom. So the what happened is, after the discussion from the old people, then the good idea pick up by the community. Mm-hmm. Then we sort of, you know, the nuclear, you know, meeting by the committee. Mm-hmm. And then committee agreed to implement such idea into the daily or coming year. Mm-hmm. Then decided, then what is, who's responsible every day, make sure it is implementing it the director. Mm-hmm. Right. You understand? Right. Oh, this is the way it's set up. Mm-hmm. You know. So therefore, in the way, our center is a democracy, you know. Everybody has something to say. Mm. Whatever best, you know, idea, you know, ology, or you know, whatever spiritual way, or whatever they can do, mm-hmm. they can say, they can contribute. Mm-hmm. So we open.
Do you think then it's really quite important for that in the communities themselves, for there to be quite regular community meetings, and that that people are encouraged to participate?
I think good idea.
Because sometimes these community meetings have actually, they've just broken down.
Yeah, I think very important, yeah.
And I think, you know, I don't want to express my own opinion, but I think one of the most valuable things is to keep a really a good spirit amongst everybody. So there's a feeling always of participation.
I think definitely idea. It's working, sort of working together, you know, and the sharing together is this very important community. Mm. Because the connotation of commune means we are common sense working together. Mm-hmm. You understand? Not the individualistic working. Mm. You understand? Even though individuals have time and space, you know, that I want you distinguished, you know. Mm. Common sense is the principle, you know. Then the individual have also individual, you know, lifestyle.
Yes. So, but now, basically, as I can hear from what you're saying, the real concept of the centers is that they are to be communities. Is this correct?
Yes, we set up community center, yes. But not all centers, our centers, are happening that way. Mm-hmm. Because some of the center is located in the city.
Yes.
And in the city, I mean, different it's community different. Again.
Okay, you know? We'll talk about that just in a minute.
Yes.
But in the sense that they're communities, they're groups of people together participating in a growing sense of developing the Mahayana Dharma. Sometimes I've felt some centers in the country, they become more like a college or a school. And the community side is pushed away a bit, and this creates conflict from the people living inside. How do you think that problem between it being a college or a community should be balanced? Or do you think they can be together?
They should be balanced. They should be balanced. First of all, I tell you one thing. College is now, characteristic of college, you know, Buddhist college is normally it is involving tremendous intellectual, you know, material, you know. I mean, it is not only, you know, a couple of months, you know. It is years involving this thing, you know. So then, those people, you know, they have separate sort of, you know, choosing certain, you know, lifestyle. And the community is just living, and daily do meditation, they receive, you know, practical how to stop it, you know. My opinion is now I tell you, my thinking is community. For the community, they cannot be sort of intellectual trip, you know, because since they are the involving lifestyle, you know, therefore, you know, they should have some kind of, you know, sort of, you know, practical teaching. Practical teaching.
On day-to-day
you
basis.
Know, day-to-day, how to solve the problem. So my understanding is actually, you know, spiritual leaders of the center have to have some kind of, you know, sympathetic, you know, to daily individuals, you know, feeling and disturbing, you know, to find out what is their disturbing, how to solve the problem, how to deal that problem. I think how to heal that problem. That is something which is almost beyond, you know, intellectual philosophy. I think that
practical.
Is practical, but very touch, very touch level. Nothing, say class, you know, sit down, you, blah 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 blah. Not like that. Something touch level, you know,
with feeling.
Yeah, just being somehow, you know, sort of working. Specifically, particularly this flower problem.
With sympathy, then?
Yeah, with the sympathy, but investigate strictly individual problem. You understand? I think this we great need, you know. Of course, sometimes,
need to listen,
you know,
yes?
Tibetan, I think Buddhist scholars, you know, teachers, they don't like to deal, you know, the individual, you know, personal problem, you know, they're not keen to do that one, you know. I think in this, you know, super samsaric, you know, materialistic, environment, this is the most important things need, you know, desperately need. Because the daily, the complication, and the symptom is a so sensitive, so strong, then general normal problem, you know.
Yes.
You understand? So therefore, I feel something, you know, my side, you know, since I try to cure wisdom, you know, pain and dissatisfy, you know, somehow I have to deal, you know, sort of directly,
individual.
You know, it even take tremendous energy, is very worthwhile. You know, if this syndrome, personal syndrome, is not suffered, then all community sick. You know, this is the different sort of, you know, dealing with the Western than East problem.
So do you think this really is Mahayana in practice?
Yes, it is Mahayana practice, yes.
In practice, actually?
Yes, in practice, yes. Definitely. So therefore, I feel, you know, that the community living situation, and we need somebody, you know, teacher who go beyond the intellectual and it just, you know, sort of psychological understanding the history of that man or woman, you know, and then deal that situation.
When you say teacher, do you mean either a Westerner who's sometime in the Dharma already, or only a Tibetan teacher?
I don't care who's you know, involved in that center, you know.
Mm.
You understand? Sometimes West teacher, sometimes East teacher, you know. Mm. I think they both have somehow, when you are dealing with the community, you should have some kind of, you know, that kind of attitude.
Mm.
Rather, you're sitting on the throne, you know, and then blah, 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 blah.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think so that is something, you know, the helpful for them.
Mm. That's a distance.
Yes, because you are distinct, then, you know, and then, you know, you not touch, you know, their heart problem.
Mm. So do you think it's worthwhile then in the communities, possibly for people to take a more active role in actually individual or small group meetings? Do you think it's...
I think good idea, you know, very good idea,
mm-hmm.
very good idea, at least, you know, once a month.
Mm.
Have to have some kind of, you know, healing system,
mm-hmm.
each other, you know?
Mm.
I think that's what we need. Because sometimes I feel like our centers, people sort of pretending they are, you know, sort of busy because they are learning their room, they have their, you know, their job, without their, you know, learning philosophy.
Mm.
They show always busy aspects, you know, but not in the center. Sometimes
there's no personal contact each other. Mm. How can you? How could be sort of, you know, sharing? If you're not contact, mm-hmm. I don't know, sharing. Mm-hmm. Somehow I have to have some kind of connection. Mm-hmm. How do you think then in the centers, the teaching situation itself, the formal teaching situation, should develop? In the you have the programs throughout the year, and you have the general teachings given by the lamas from the geshes from India, from Tibet. How do you think there should be balance between the teaching situation and the community work? Do you think this will develop in stages, or do you think there, on a day-to-day basis, there needs to be time for both? So we were talking about the balance between college activities,
yes.
and the community activities, which
yes.
obviously in the beginning,
yes.
the community activities have to be very big because we usually have a physical problem
that's what I mean.
On our hands,
I know.
Namely living situation.
Now, there is something not clear, in other words, I think.
Mm.
There's something have to be clear within the community.
Mm-hmm.
And also teachers or ministers, everybody should have some clarity. Now, my opinion, you know. Now, I just give you opinion. Why? If we have clear idea, community means just normal living life, you know,
mm.
just do it, you know, whatever necessary to do it, isn't it? Mm. You know, take care of physical, you know, health and cleaning, you know, food, clothes, just normal family life, you know, but same time, you know, mind practicing. That is the emphasis. Just have to know, clean, clear. That is the their job. And clean, clear, they are not intellectual, should not be intellectual ambition, you know.
What should not?
Ambition, intellectual, philosophical, you know, ambition, you know, to learn.
You mean that should not be the aim?
Yeah, there should not be aim
of the people.
Yeah, to be sort of, you know, philosophical, you know, sort of, you know, mind, you know. And if you aim this one, then the conflict comes. You know, let's say you are the first. I make example. You are sort of, you know, family, baby, you know, wife, situation. You are intensively, you know, and sort of involved with your own lifestyle. You know, and then I say, you know, I'm the teacher. I say, you know, the Madhyamaka philosophy I teach, you know, why don't you come? You lose your opportunity. Madhyamaka philosophy is so important for your liberation. You understand? Then you say, oh, my Lama says, that's true. And my life is short time. You know, I don't care my wife now. It's true. My wife is secondary. Just transitory, you know, he's transitory, my baby is transitory, you know, confessional. I think I need absolute achievement, so that's true. I give up all these things, you know, I go to Madhyamaka philosophy. Madhyamaka philosophy, Tibetan system, I mean intellectual system, I talk about it, you know. It took you at least 4 years, Tibetan system, you know. And then you neglected completely. You know, 4 years, your wife and your children. I mean, this is totally wrong. Then, I tell you, then sickness comes. Sickness comes. Symptom comes, you know. If you do that one, you know. I mean, okay, if you can do, I mean, you know, but you cannot do anyway, you know. Because you split yourself, you know. You understand? Then, too much family problem comes, you know. When the family problem comes, you cannot do anything. You cannot learn anything because you are troubling, you know, and distorted by so many complications, you know, argument, you know, all permanent. I think your mind is two-way split, you know. Then that's why my opinion is, those our Dharma family, you know, Dharma families, they should do earthly. You know what I mean? You know, earthly develop. They should keep their job. They should make money. They should live comfortably. They give good comfort for their wife and children. Just be normal. You know, then the, you know, life, of course, you practice at the same time, but not, you know, involving entire life, you know, 24 hours, you know, intellectual field. I really feel there are enormous problems. Yes. And then break down, you know, and a marriage couple, they started their problem, you know. So that's what I say. It needs clean, clear, you know, to area, understood everybody, you know. They should not put down, they should not push you to this, you to that, you to that. Just some kind of reasonable, you know, capacity. Each area understood, clean, clear. So then there's no conflict.
So in other words, each individual should be very precise in understanding their own responsibilities.
Right, yes.
In the community,
yes.
To themselves.
Right.
And to their families or people
exactly, yes.
Who they're with.
Exactly, yes.
And then would that determine how much time the individual could then put into the studies.
Absolutely.
Themselves.
Absolutely. You know.
So that the studies, in the college sense, Lama, you feel should come second. Practical sense.
Yes, I think so. Because, see, you know, it's tremendous involvement, you know, time and space, you know.
Mm.
Therefore, if you cannot put, you know, push that situation.
Mm.
Yeah.
So it's really a matter of being realistic.
Yes, it's realistic, yes. I think that's my point. Yes, you're right. My point is sometimes in the center, student confused, you know, and the day becomes unrealistic, you know. The reason is, somebody says this, you know.
Mm.
You understand?
Yes.
And yes, they try to do it. And then sometimes they too much rely upon their, you know, lama or teacher, you know.
Mm.
You understand?
Yes.
I think personally, my opinion is, I think they should not expecting that, you know, all community is sort of, you know, daily, everything is by teachers saying that this, you know. They should not expect that. I don't believe myself, you know.
Mm. The teacher answers all their questions.
Yeah.
About everything they do.
Oh, they're wrong, you know.
Mm.
Definitely wrong. Then the result is too much confusion. Too much, you know, conflict come.
Mm.
And then it destroy devotion or then destroy everything. Isn't it? I really truly believe, you know, to some extent, I can make my own decision. When I come from Tibet, I left Tibet, nobody tell me, you leave Tibet, you know. No one tell me. Everybody say, you not go. You understand?
Yes.
But somehow, my intuition, I want to go. I don't want to go where there is no, you know, communist ideological control me. You know, and like to be, rest my life to be monk. You understand? That's the reason I come myself, you know. No one, my teacher told me, you must go get out from Tibet.
Mm.
Isn't it? You understand what I mean?
You use your own intelligence.
Yes, I make my own decision.
Because I think there's a tendency.
That is truthful, I tell you. In other words, I feel truthful. I don't like, you know, my guru said they did this, you know. I don't think so, really, you know.
So
somebody is exactly make you eat, you drink, you know, you make your own life, you know. I think you have to trust your Buddha nature, some extent, you know. Of course, you listen advice, you know, your guru told you when he keep teaching, he told you everything, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it? Entire universal life, he explained. Entire, you know, six realms of life, isn't it? Entire, from beginning, renunciation up to enlightenment, already advanced, you know. So then you know already. Other sense, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so why are you asking? You know, daily is a blah, 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 ask you, it's not true.
So the decisions for every day, the situation should be made by ourselves.
Yes.
In the communities.
Yes. Then you avoid confusion, you know.
Mm-hmm. But then, what areas do you feel the teachers themselves should be limited to in terms of advice?
Well, teachers themselves.
Because sometimes the reason
teachers have to know themselves their own limitation, you know. You understand?
Yes.
So that if they are not clear, you know, difficult to advise.
Mm.
You understand? I don't know New Zealand people's lifestyle, you know. I cannot say we choose Brian, you are a New Zealand boy. Therefore, you stay in the cave 20 years, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's just completely out of, you know, sky, you know. I talk about nonsense, you know.
That's true.
Yes.
So then...
Therefore, I'm not telling you, you know.
perhaps I'd like you to tell me, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
I think I think it would be helpful for people to have an idea on what subjects they should go to the teachers for, in a general sense.
Yes, you know? A general case. I think, like the lumbering particle, absolute particle. Lumbering is something, you know, my wish, you know, my wish, if you want, my interpretation. All of the our central people, first thing is lumbering. The lumbering answers you everything, all lifestyle problems, you know. Then, after then, you know, sometimes lojong, you know, lojong answers completely into the lumbering. Then, all particle, you know, particle things, you know, something, particle things, you could put, you know, directly into the category of lumbering daily life. I think this is the essential thing. Such and this is the need it so much for Western environment and Western people. Mm-hmm. And by then, I really believe, you know, they become good Buddhists. You understand what I mean? You know? Mm-hmm. They become good Mahayana Sith. Mm-hmm. And by then, everything you tell things, they put it into the, you know, part of the liberation.
Yes. Yes. So you think then that the questions that, or the advice that the students in the center should approach the teachers for is advice regarding the lamrim, the practice, how to bring into daily life, or questions about theory,
oh, yes,
questions about the parameters.
No, really. I think my personal is, I tell you, something beautiful West is going to come into Dharma. Mm. I tell you, something unique. You know, it's completely different than, you know, East people to study Dharma. Mm. That part I like, you know. West people who come Dharma, most of them, they fed up, you know, lifestyle. They fed up society system. You understand? They fed up, you know, the materialistic life, you know. And they pull up, you know, conflict, you know, into the society. That's the reason they come for Dharma. You understand? And they fed up with, you know, politics, you know, game.
So already there's some of that.
Yes. I truly believe they are the truly readiness, you know, quality. And so that kind of student truly seeking something, boiling water to put something ice.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Yes.
And this is the, you know, I think what can make ice into the water is the lumbering. Mm-hmm. You know, making, understanding their own conflict situation of their own life and how you cope, how you look at into the problem. You know, how to solve this problem, it is directly talking about them, you know. And then there's no argument. When you talk philosophy, they say, no, you are wrong. You understand?
Yes.
You talk about this philosophy, East philosophy, you know, it's a banana, you know. We have the philosophy, we said this way, you said this way, you are wrong. Mm-hmm. They're going to argument.
Mm-hmm.
But when we talk about strictly their own problem, you know, their own conflict, and how to deal that problem, how can they deny?
Mm-hmm.
They cannot deny. And they surprise also, you know, why this man know my problem, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Not that this man know, but this man started with the psychology, you know? So that reason, you know, so something we have to offer
mm-hmm.
was the people.
Yes.
Yeah. And I really, my, you know, experience, you know, I'm not trying to talk, you know, sophisticated Buddhist philosophy to the Western mind. I don't care, you know.
Mm.
You understand? Because, you know, it's not helping for them. What I try to do is the essential aspect of Buddhism, you know, which subject is old, you know, over 2,000, more than 2,500 years. But I put sort of new, you know, sort of color, you know, new clothes, you know.
Mm.
You know what I mean, you know? And somehow link it, you know, with their own, you know, culture.
Mm.
And this is the way, no way they out.
So we are to try to practice Buddhism, and if it becomes Western Buddhism,
yes, I think that though. I really truly believe, you know, Buddhism should be something Western people's mind, Western thing, Western mind, Western spirits, you know, Western consciousness. And I'm not impassive to anything, you know, Tibetan culture aspect, you know, rituals, you know, Dharma, K, this thing. I don't believe anyway, first of all, you know. You understand? Time, Buddhist time, there's no cake making as Tibetan style. You understand? Tibetan style is same thing as Western do. Western, there is food, fruit, and whatever you eat, what do you offer that one? I think that is the right thing. You know? And sometimes I wonder also that too much emphasis for the rituals, you know? You know, not emphasis on the internal ritual of meditation. You understand? That is, I think, again, something you lose, you know, the principle and, you know, emphasis on the secondary, you know, things. And therefore, I really truly say, Western student should not try to copy exactly ritual, you know, the superficial color Tibetan to bring in the West, you know. And they try to bring the essence of Buddhism, you know, essence of the Dharma, essence of Sangha, you know, in the West environment. What I'm saying is that the Dharma, Buddha Dharma bring West world is, we have to bring the essential and the nuclear part of Buddha Dharma, and not, you know, should not emphasize to bring Dharma as a ritual. A ritual is something sort of specific, you know, archetype of Tibetan. And I remember also, His Holiness Dalai Lama recently, his lecture, he says, some of the Tibetan, you know, rituals, they sort of, you know, compromise, you know, as Tibetan culture. Or in other words, he said, if something manipulated, you know, the idea of Buddhism into the society, you know, play game. I hope I'm not mistaken, you know, I remember, you know. So not exactly words, but I hope essence catch. So therefore, I think, you know, it is very important. One should decide it, you know. I think one should make a decision, you know, to make decision that I'm not want something copy of Tibetan culture. I just want, I'm a Westerner, I live as Westerner, but Buddha Dharma is no doubt for my path to liberation. So that essence I take. For instance, my early, you know, meeting with Westerners, also I tried to experiment everything, you know, a sort of more scientific level. And I tried to emphasize they wear exactly Tibetan copy, you know, they to wear robes, and, you know what I mean, retreat style, is we made dharmas and rituals, and dorji, and bell, and I try to emphasize, you know. But now my, you know, scientific experience with Western people, somehow my observation, you know, with, you know, my patients, you know, and it changes. because when I'm involved with these people, you know, for example, I went to, you know, Western monk, I went into the city. Where's the city? Some of the Western society people make spirit like this, you know, on my monk, you know. You understand? They do like that, you know. Mm. I'm not blind both, you know. I'm not blind too. I understand, you know. Mm. And I have, you know, sort of inside my heart, you know, sort of somehow, emotionally, you know, compassion for my monk, you know, Western monk. He's good man, you know. he tried to live, you know, honest life. He tried to renounce his, you know, worldly pleasure. He tried to do his best. And he's a good man, you know. But only his behavior, you know, cutting, you know, having bald head, and wearing, you know, the monk robe, you know, making him, you know, become kaka, you know, in West, you know, city, you know. I thought it's not fair, you know, such, you know, wonderful human being, you understand? And to put situation, you know, as a garbage bag, you know, spirit, you know, object. I thought it's so incredible. I'm not fair. I thought I'm not fair. I told them, you wear this robe, you know. And they listening to me. I thought I'm stupid, you know. I shouldn't, you know, pull. And also, you know, not only, you know, only my own experience. The Buddha himself said, you know, the Vinaya rule, the time and the space, time changed, you know. You know, and then the you know, changed the Vinaya rule according the measure of element of people's mind. We have clear explanation, and therefore, I you know sort of discussed in the Western you know student you know publicly how you felt, you know. I didn't say my experience, how you feel West monk, you know, Western people wear Tibetan style, you know, robe. Mm-hmm. You know, when I was giving course in Amsterdam, you know, mm-hmm. in Holland, most people said, no good. Mm-hmm. You know, Buddhism is the, you know, democracy. Mm-hmm. You know, Buddhism is for the people. So the most people said, you know, you shouldn't wear. Then that is the evidence. We shouldn't wear. You know? Also, good example. Buddhism went from the India to China, to Korea, to Tibet, to Japan, to many many countries. Everybody wear different role. You understand? That means they did accordingly its own environment. Element of his own population's mind. Therefore, I think my opinion is Western people should develop their own cultural heritage of somehow archetype, you know, behavior of Buddhist monk and nun. Yeah.
Brings me to a good subject, Lama, and that is the how do you feel the monks and nuns in the communities should live within the communities if the communities are mixed communities.
Yeah, I understand. Well, I think, you know, it is easier if there are separate living situations because environment itself is supporting what their philosophy, what their psychology, what they are, you know, ethics. Mm-hmm. You understand? And it is very essential to have separate environment. Mm-hmm. I agree. But first beginning, we are the you know, new society. And to have, you know, nunnery, separate nunnery, the monk, is tremendous, you know, it's involving $100,000 worth, you know, energy. Mm. And I think we have to accept according our resource, you know. Mm-hmm. So that it took me time, many years, mm. and now, you know, we are lucky at France, we established Nalanda Monastery, mm-hmm. so the monk can go there. And I can see that many difficult, you know, monk nuns having, you know, such a responsibility, you know, and ethics according to Vinaya rule, mm-hmm. and they have to live as exactly in the Western sort of lay people's environment. Mm-hmm. is very difficult. I couldn't, you know.
So you think the long-term view for people in the communities considering the future of the monastic community and how to keep it strong should be they should look to ways of keeping the or developing the monks and nuns separately so they have their own environment.
Right.
Yes?
Definitely, yes. Mm. Absolutely. Even though we are home, entire universal community, you know, but they should have their own space, you know. You understand what I mean? You know? At the same time, they come into the, you know, universal community. You know?
Mm.
I think so, yes. And then they become strong.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
First, you have to exist in yourself, you know,
in
order to, you know, benefit yourself effectively to others.
This was actually the reason the Buddha established the Sangha in the first place, wasn't
it? That's right, exactly, yeah. Mm. That's right, yes. That's right, yes.
So they could be the strong holders of the tradition, the pure
exactly,
tradition.
Yes. That's right, yes. I really hope, you know, in the future, that the Nalanda Monastery is, you know, sort of nuclear, you know, to preserve.
Lama, this brings me to a good point, and that is the relationship of the lay community to the monastic community. And in a very real sense, the responsibility of one to the other. How do you see those responsibilities in the broad sense of the lay community to the monastic community and opposite, vice versa?
Well, you mean relationship between the lay community and the monk community, nuns community. Well, first of all, we all linked, you know, one community. And we should understood that way, first of all, you know. And the secondly, we have to support each other, you know. Whatever we have, you know, spiritually and materially, we share each other. And that kind of attitude we should have. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
You know, the sense, you know, what I'm saying, the sense that lay people should feel that monk and nuns, they choose their life, is so worthwhile. Their need, you know. And their need helps for me, even though I'm lay people.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I mean? At the same time, monk nuns should feel that you know that lay people also they need that kind of you know lifestyle, that kind of environment for them. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
And that is the right thing for them. You understand? So therefore, sort of acceptable, instead of put down.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So mutually respect each other, you know, by understanding each people need individual growth, you know, individual, you know, sort of phenomenon to exercise relatively.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, absolutely, you know, of course, you cannot judge, you know, like Domtomba, like Milarepa, you know. I mean, they are much better than common sense monk, nun. You understand? So therefore, I mean, relatively, you know, we are working sort of, you know, individual need, you know, and therefore should accept each other and support each other anyway, ideologically or materially or whatever it is. You know.
How do you think, talking about support in a general sense, how do you think the support of the communities should develop? How should the communities become self-sufficient?
Well, I think, you know, I mean, my understanding, I'm sure I don't understand exactly, you know, what it means. But my gross understanding, I tell you, I feel any community in the world, you understand, one should live, it is sufficient, you know, according to their own environment, economy, standard.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, our, you know, community also should work, you know, to some extent in order to support themselves and the community and to benefit, you know, mm-hmm. for others too.
Do you think the communities should support themselves by the courses, for example? Do you think that should be one of the ways they should support themselves?
No, I disagree. You know? Mm. No way. No way, I think, our experience, you know.
Mm.
I mean, there's no historical that the community supported by the giving Dharma for others. There's no historical, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? No possible, I think, especially this, you know, materialistic country and the without working themselves, you know.
Mm.
You understand? Therefore, I think community have to work as same thing as society style and to support themselves
mm-hmm.
and live comfortable. And there is extra energy there, you contribute for the mm-hmm. you know, community development. Therefore, I feel individuals are also responsible to be healthy themselves.
Mm.
Then community become okay.
Stronger.
Yes.
I think there's sometimes a problem in the communities where people become sponsored
yes.
by the community.
That's right.
And slowly, the motivation becomes weaker because to some extent they begin to lose enthusiasm for what they're doing, and the energy becomes weaker.
Yeah.
How do you think that problem can be
Well, that I tell you something, you know. Some of the centers, they try to sponsor, you know, students for the ministering, for mm. facilitating the center.
Mm.
And I'm sure, as you say, the situation, some people have some problem.
Mm.
However, now there is stage to development, you know, mm. center. I don't think so, really, you know, any center of our center, any of our center is ready to really sponsor, you know, about 20, 30 people.
Mm.
I feel it's not realistic, you know. No, honestly, you know. Mm. Because we are, you know, building something constructive, you know. And we have so much, you know, to fix the, you know, facility. You understand? And at the same time, we are sponsored these things. I think it's just maybe dreaming. I mean, this is my interpretation, excuse me, you know.
Mm.
I don't know, should do or shouldn't do. I feel we are development stage, we are beginner. You know?
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, how can you afford, you know, to sponsor, you know, 30 people? You understand? We are not, you know, Dharma is we not making commotion, you know.
Mm.
You understand?
Mm.
We are not making business, you know. So try to sponsor, you know, 30, 40 people, you know, from the income of, you know, I think very difficult.
Mm.
Very difficult, I think, my opinion. Therefore, I think somehow the concerning community, we should have, you know, set up workshop on some reason income in order to lead their situation.
Mm.
I think creativity, you know, and making creativity, you know, job, I think essential thing.
So you think
in order to exist and stable. If you don't want, you know, stable community, you understand? It's like butterfly, you know. You understand?
Always coming, going.
Right, coming, going, coming, going. Mm. Then I think no group anymore.
So your real vision of the community should be more stable.
Yes.
In terms of the
more
people that are living
exactly
in the communities, they should look at the time they're living in the communities with a long-range vision.
Absolutely, yes. Yes. That's my feeling.
Mm.
That's my understanding. You know.
And to do that,
yes,
they then should be encouraged to develop some professional skill or business,
yes,
something that's going to allow them to support themselves.
I agree that, you know. I told, you know, all the center people that the director is well, I say, you know, because I don't have any other things, other people to say.
Mm.
I say, director is not easy job. What is the director job? Director is keeping community together, you know, by spiritually, you know, to facilitate. You know what I mean? You know, to make sure they get, you know, what they need, you know, spiritually take care of, and materially, some extent, they take care of. By not the giving, you know, like this, you know, we don't have. By utilizing the skill, you know, by facilitating skill, you understand what I mean? You know, directing those people how to do, which way to do, which way to, you know, standing their life. Because I believe, you know, all those people who come in institute, you know, community, they are so intelligent, actually, you know, intelligent, and maybe lazy, you know, and that has to be sort of skillfully, you know, making psychologists, you know, have to be, you know, chef, you know, to make chef, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I think so. Therefore, job creation, I think, very important.
At this stage and in the future?
Yes, all the time. Because people come there with a lot of problems, anxiety, and uncooked society. And they want some cooked situation, and at the same time, they live life. So that we are making these people better life, you know, isn't it? So therefore, we take responsible. If you cannot take responsible creativity, you know, or sort of growth, I think you should not accept, you know, to be community people.
Yes.
I think we mistake, you know, we cheating people.
Mm.
You understand what I mean?
So you think there should be more, shall we say, discrimination?
I think so, yes.
In terms of allowing people to join the communities,
yes, the sense
are not going
grow
to be able to support themselves in the sense of either one of two things, obviously, either they have the fortune to have some financial backing,
yes,
on their own side,
right?
Or they have a skill that they can bring into the community, creative,
right?
Skill that they can in the community develop and continue to be self-sufficient,
right?
You think
or
it's a
somehow, you know, potentially, you know, we can train him, you know, maybe he you know,
oh,
nothing,
yes,
you know,
yes,
we can train him how to make wood, you know, you know, something, you know, wood part, you know, you understand what I mean, you know, or candle standard, you know,
right, right.
And then he can support himself, you know.
Sure.
So many times the people, you know, they don't know they can support themselves, but they have so much, you know, potential.
Yes.
They can make Buddha themselves, you know, or they can make, you know, business, you understand what I mean, you know.
Yes.
Yeah, they can play with wood, they can play with earth. They can make clay, you know. For example, excuse me, Manjushri Institute, we have also, you know, the clay making, you know, the
pottery.
Equipment, pottery equipment.
I
mean, pottery is expensive.
Any
England, one kind of, you know, small porcelain, sort of, you know, you have to pay about, you know, three, four, five pounds, you know.
Yes.
So it's worthwhile. If one cannot make, that one, how, what kind of people, you know?
What
kind of human being? Then better to resolve, you know?
Lama, what relationship then, if somebody is in the community, this is quite important, I think, because I see the long-term success of the communities depending upon this self-sufficiency of the individuals. What relationship should a business in the community have to the community itself?
Excuse me, I'm not clear.
How
to make, you mean?
If somebody establishes a business and they're living and working in the community, who owns the business?
Yes, I understand.
In simple language.
Okay, that it can be done such way.
Because there has to be some incentive.
That's scientifically researched. That should be scientifically researched.
Uh-huh.
It's important, not the ideological.
Mm.
My opinion is, scientific research is, let's say, pottery, you know. If magician, let's say I'm the student, magician institute set up for me pottery, you know, equipment, everything. How much, you know, house, set up that equipment, how much money involved, scientifically, isn't it? Then I'm making that one, you know, and how much product I produce.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So, I say that two ways to do. I say, this is my job, my living, whatever scientifically cause, you understand, to leave this community, you understand, I pay my work. Beyond that, the extra left over is I keep my pocket, my freedom. If I say, fine, then what is my obligation is I have to pay rent, this place, isn't it? Reasonable, you know. But this goes into the community, you know. You understand what I mean? This renting and equipment, everything is I paying for the community to develop, you know. So the business is straight, clean. So I paying whatever is, you know, is necessary for my food, my living, and my things. And if I make more skill, then belongs to what, you know, my freedom, you know, I give community, or I give my friend, or I give my children, or I give Buddha, or you know what I mean, you know, or I give third world, it's my freedom. So, I tell you, beginning, if one started that kind of business, the director has have sense enough to make completely clear, beginning. So the latter, there's no, you know, sort of, you know, complaint in the public. Am I speaking sort of,
yes,
you know?
Yes.
I think
so,
reasonable, you know?
When somebody is approaching the establishing of a business, they should just look at it in a traditional business-like way.
Exactly.
You have a facility, you're going to use the facility.
It's normal, you know?
You pay a rent on the facility.
Exactly.
You take responsibility, obviously, for the materials or something.
Absolutely,
you
yes.
pay for those. You produce
exactly.
a product.
Exactly.
You make profit.
Exactly.
From the profit, you give
normal.
For your rent.
Agree.
Ta-ta. Like
yeah,
that.
That's why, you know, exactly. It's normal, you know. We are normal, you know. Even though we are, you know, become Buddhist, you know, we still buy bread and butter, you know. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
You renounce life. You know, you still eat bread butter, you know. You understand? You cannot renounce, you know, not to eat, you know, the sense of, you know, bread butter. then you lead to death, you know. So therefore, I think, you know, that's very important thing. Even though we are, you know, Buddhist, you know, and supposedly to be renounced, everybody, you know, and however, you know, we have to live, you know, normal life, you know. You know, selling, buying is something normal, you know. In West world, if you're not selling, buying, you're not existent anyway. You know, that is the entire universal modern world, modern law. Universal modern law is you have money, you can go, you can walk, you have no money, you cannot breathing, you cannot walk.
It seems to be. That's right.
Unfortunately, you know what can I say?
This is practical reality.
So, yes. You know, that was, you know, so difficult. I don't think so. It's difficult, you know. I mean, no, I have, you know, positive sides too. Because Wesley is somehow, we are orientation of materialistic life. And this also has advantage. You can support easily, amazingly, you know. You understand? in third world, you know, to make money, to make living is so difficult. Here it seems, you know, very easy. That's why people become most times crazy. because you know they don't have anything to worry about the food and the clothes. They only, you know, think about the, you know, miserable of your fantasy, you know. So that is their problem.
Yes, this is the opposite problem.
Yeah, opposite problem, yes, exactly. Yes. That's I say, you know, Western problem, East problem different, you know. Third world people's problem and here different problem.
But we can certainly take advantage of value we have in the West.
Definitely.
For the development of the centers.
Definitely, you know. I really feel some extent, you know, the nuclear of Buddha Dharma, Western people better understand, you know, and then a third world country. Because third world country is too much occupied, you know, too much occupied by the, material, you know, conflict, you know. You understand, not having enough. But here is too much enough. So therefore, you know, you had everything. You had everything, you know. So what you gain, you know, you discover, you know, those material game is gaining nothing which you have, you know. What you don't have, say, they mean nothing. You know, they don't believe, you know. They are something, isn't it? So I think for that reason, Western people is hungry down. You understand? By readiness, you know, not the intellectual, you know, feel.
Lama, could we talk just briefly about your concept of the city centers? We've spoken now, and I think generally about the larger communities and their overall situation. But as we've seen, so many of us in the West, we're from cities, and we're living in cities, and this is a very intense environment. And you now have many centers that are in the cities. We're fortunate in London to have very good geshe in one. Many cities they have. How do you think those centers should develop?
Well, first of all, city center should be, you know, different than the country's, you know, community center.
What purpose?
Pardon?
What purpose?
Purpose is, of course, you know, to developing, you know, oneself, you know, and to bring peace oneself, you know, I mean others. But what I'm saying is this way. Different is, orientation is should be different, you know. Why? First of all, city center should be somehow strong emphasis, strong meditation, my opinion.
Strong meditation?
Yes, emphasis on the strong meditation.
Mm.
Not too much involving sort of, you know, ritual, prayers, you know, because the city situation is so strong.
Mm.
You understand? This, you know, ritual, these things are not enough power, you know, to sensitive, you know, delusion to come down. Therefore, you need strong meditation, short time to shortcut. Because city people, they don't have time. You know what I mean? You know, they don't have time, space, you know. So therefore, should be something clean cut through short time. You know? And therefore, I think in my opinion, it should be something, silent meditation, you know, and should be more emphasis. And I feel city center should be facilitated 24 hours, just open. Anyone who come, just sit there, meditate.
How big do you think a city center should be, realistically?
Well, that depends how developed, you know. I mean, this time, practically speaking, maybe this much. Mm-hmm. Temple is this much enough. Mm-hmm. You know, this much. Something feet, 100 people, you know. And then any time, for example, I'm walking somewhere near the center, mm-hmm. you know, I'm walking, and my lunch time, I finish my job, and I shortcut, I drink coffee, I come down here, I just relax, meditate. Then I can go there. Anytime, access, my opinion is, access to come, take refuge, you know, mm-hmm. take quality peaceful, should make temple, you know what I mean, mm-hmm. you know, Gomba, mm-hmm. you know, something soundful, mm-hmm. very peaceful. Just being Gomba, sort of bliss out, mm-hmm. you know. One should make that environment. And then enter the emphasis on the meditation. Mm. Yes.
During the week program.
Yes, that's right. Mm. Not too much intellectual training. Mm. Because there's no time. Mm. Then another thing, I expressed many times to the, you know, city center directors that they should make some kind of, you know, sort of meeting, you know, a meeting, you know, coming, you sort of, you know, party. You understand what I mean? You know, a tea party or dinner party or somehow to be gathering, you know, mm-hmm. and in a light way, Dharma orientation, mm-hmm. just relax, you know, somehow Dharma brothers used to come together and share, you know, we are same time we drinking, we eating, but share Dharma experience, you know. And maybe sometimes we're dancing, you know. Mm-hmm. We are dancing, you know. Dharma gurus, we dance, short meditation, maybe 10 minutes we meditate, mm-hmm. you know, then we dance. I mean, you know what I mean, you know. Mm-hmm. And then I can sit down, talk, relax, drink, you know. Mm-hmm. And maybe before we split, again meditation, you know, couple minutes, and dedicate, good night, sleep.
You know. It's a very good idea.
I think it is important that, you know, in Western environment, cities, people close each other totally. I don't know my neighbor who is, who isn't, you know. And this, you know, sort of, you know, the hard, you know, life should be break down by bringing together, you understand, human touch each other. You understand? The sense, common goal, common sense. And this is the way we can stimulate Dharma in the Western, you know, city. Because, you know, because it's not true businessman who can, you know, meditate, deep meditation. He cannot do. But he lonely. He desperately needs relaxation. So you're giving your friend who are businessmen an opportunity way to relax inside himself and satisfy, you know, relaxation by doing dancing or by singing or you understand what I mean, you know? Mm-hmm. And by you know, I don't know,
participating,
you know, mm-hmm. somehow manipulate his mind, you know, transforming into the, you know, tranquility peaceful. I think that will have to be developed, my opinion is. And that is, I call that worldly environment, you know, five sense, secondary, you know, the object, into the, you know, Dharma, into the path to liberation. That should be developed. I think way to bring Dharma West to the world is one should have skill, you know, many different ways to make Dharma. You know, one should not have fixed an idea. Mm-hmm. You know, that is very important, I think.
Flexibility is a key.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. Flexibility. Otherwise, you can never make any Dharma at all. Because you are caught with the, you know, otherwise your advantage of the culture of the, you know, Dharma. Mm-hmm. You understand? You are not relating situation Dharma. Lama should be related when you're eating, you know, when you're drinking, when you're walking, when you are dancing, when you are, you know, sleeping, when you are, you understand? There's something there, that is the, you know, Buddhist skill. Every situation, it can be taking, you know, oriented Dharma situation. You know?
This is true for both city centers and country centers and monastic centers? I think
so,
yes.
I think so. We should do that kind of thing. Yes. And I think also, you know, it's good things, Dharma centers are related with, you know, many artists, you know, people who created, you know, some kind of, you know, psychological reality. And they should be related, you know, also musicians, you know. Musicians, they have, you know, somehow powerful, you know, sort of, you know, method to manipulate any reality into any kind of, you know, form of sound, you know, isn't it? So we are involving transformation involving every energy into the, you know, sort of, you know, positive way. We should bring that kind of thing. We should bring the singing, you know, singing is, you know, and sort of expressed universal love. Singing is expressed equilibrium. Singing is expressed, you know, bodhicitta. Singing is expressed universal reality of non-duality. Then what, you know? Then what is the problem, you know? What is the problem to dance, you know? Huh? If somebody can make, you know, singing non-duality feeling, express sunyata singing, huh? Yes, I think one should make great path to enlightenment, the entire lumbering of entire, you know, tantra beginning up to end into the singing.
Should make a rock and roll.
And record. Dancing, you know. I think perfect. That is a perfect way we transforming Western culture into the, you know, the positive.
Incredible.
I think so.
Yes. So that means really, with wisdom, with skill, and with understanding, everything that is positive can be taken.
Yeah. Let's. I make one example.
Into.
You know? Yes. I make one example. That's right. That's right. I make one example. When we do, you know, Lama Chöpa, you know, Tara Puja, or this thing, I think, my opinion is, you can use Western instrument for the singing, for the sound offering. Yes, I think so, you know. Definitely. Maybe change some kind of, you know, another expression, you know. You know what I mean, you know? I think we use, you know. What, you know, why not, you know? Why not? In Tibetan, any good making sound they used one time. You understand? Lama Chöpa Puja, sometimes they use this, you know,
symbols.
And this one also used. I saw sometimes they use this one.
Small bells.
Yeah, small bell you can use too.
Yes.
There is some kind of logical for me, you know. Any good sound you can operate. Isn't it?
So anything which actually encourages
yes,
a joyous energy,
exactly,
for the offering,
right,
should be brought in.
Absolutely, yes. That's all.
Lama, I think we have to finish here. I'm sorry.
Really?
Right? Or is it still happening?
All right, we are over now. Yeah. Are you, Brian? Are you satisfied now?
Yes, Lama.
Really? Is there more questions you have?
No.
Really.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
There's questions.
Thank you so much.
Your answers were just
thank you so
really
much.
Wonderful.
No, thank you so much. Okay, yeah.